Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best of Slot with what is unfortunately not a happy, happy video. I've just got back from Insomnia 52. As you can see, I've just woke up as well. And I can't really upload tonight anyway, and there's a video we need to do because it's quite important. I think it's important for people, fans of this channel in particular. So I thought we'd do it just in case people aren't aware or... Not even just that, it's a nice place for people to do things. Well, I'll explain. On August 24th, 2014, Richard Attenborough died. Richard Attenborough was the man who, amongst many, many, many other things, including Gives Him Miracle on 34th Street, directed Gandhi, which won 2 Oscars, you know, fantastic, talented man, was John Hammond in Jurassic Park, the first film and the second film. Was he in the third? No idea. John Hammond in the first 2 films, and obviously as such a prominent actor in the Jurassic Park series, that's got quite a lot of relevance to me, that's got quite a lot of relevance to you guys who grew up watching Jurassic Park and loving Jurassic Park. So I want to do a quick video, basically, for a start, for somewhere to people to offer their own condolences, because the problem is that he's just passed away, family, trauma, etc. A lot of people will be going on Twitter and stuff. A lot of people don't use Twitter. A lot of people will be just posting Facebook statuses, but a lot of people don't like Facebook, blah blah blah. So if people want to say a little thing or just a little RIP or whatever, there's a video for that now, or there's a comment section for that now, I suppose. I'm going to disable ads on this video if I can, if my network lets me, but I just want to talk for a minute basically about Richard Attenborough. I've not really thought this through, in case you can't tell, I'm shattered, but it's important. It is. It's important. This whole channel exists because of Jurassic Park. Full stop. You know, the only reason I currently sit here and can do this in a flat and, you know, have this job is because of Jurassic Park. That's the whole reason this whole thing started. And growing up watching Jurassic Park, Richard Attenborough was a huge part of that experience, of the huge part of what made Jurassic Park Jurassic Park. It's a little weird, it always used to really annoy me. He's written so differently in the film than he is in the book. In the book, Attenborough would be this, like, cranky and somewhat evil old man who was just desperate for money and, you know, that kind of stuff. But in the film, obviously, he was very, very kind and loved his grandchildren and all this kind of stuff. And whilst it made it more family-friendly, Attenborough was fantastic at this kind of ability to, at one moment, be very calm and happy and family friendly, you know, hugging Lex and Timmy as they came up the staircase and stuff, and then he'd go bloody mental, like, a few minutes later. There's a bit, I'm trying to think, there's a part of the film where he just kind of screams, like, everything's falling apart, and he just kind of goes, and sort of yells at the camera, and there's a little bit of the sexist joke with, I can't even remember her name now. What's the main woman called? I can't remember. Ellie? I think it's Ellie. Oh, you know, it should be me who goes, because I'm a, and you're a. We can discuss sexism in the workplace later, that kind of thing. He was funny, he was kind, and he had this ability, to an extent, to drop the kindness and just go bloody mental. He was also very, very good at funeral? Oh god, that's... Words. Miracle on 34th Street, which is like this black and white Christmas film, really good. One of the first films I watched with my girlfriend, so it did mean quite a lot as well. I like to sit here and pretend I've seen all of his work, or, I mean, I never saw Gandhi, never saw any of that. I'd love to sit here and pretend that, but I didn't. I know Mr. John Hammond from Jurassic Park, and that's John Hammond from Jurassic Park. He, you know, was important. He was an important part of the film. He's an important important figure in that whole process. And I think anyone who has contributed so greatly to a piece of work that we pretty much universally, as a group of people, as a group of subscribers, a group of channels, loved, deserves a moment of respect, you know, and deserves to be acknowledged in that community. Now, I'm sure this is happening all over the place anyway. but I'd like to think it does have significant meaning more for quite a few people here. Yeah, he's an important guy for us. And it's just lost, he's gone. But on the other hand, he was born in, I'm going to double check this, I think, I want to say 1924, 1923, August 29th. So he was alive for 91 years old he was. 91 years old. That's bloody crazy. Absolutely bloody crazy. 91 years old. He had a better life than most of us can hope for. So I hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, that's about it. Sorry this is a mess. I want to say something, I wasn't sure what. There's a crazy loud noise outside. I don't know what the hell's going on. But Richard Attenborough, rest in peace. You were fantastic.